I'm Tammy Kolda, an applied mathematician, and this is Unlocking LaTeX Graphics. Today I'm going to show you how to embellish text and equations using TikZ. Essentially, you turn whatever you want to embellish, be it a letter in an equation or a segment of text, into a TikZ node, and then you can reference it later and add whatever you want onto that. I'll show this in the context of creating a Beamer presentation. This is often where you'd want to use such embellishments. There are some special details which I will, of course, explain. I have many more videos on TikZ and PGF plots, which I urge you to check out. These videos are based on my book, Unlocking LaTeX Graphics, as well as some bonus materials. I've already created the preamble for our document today. I'm using the Beamer document class in order to create slides, though what I'll use today can be used with any document class. I'm including hyperref only so that I can link the author name back to this YouTube channel. We'll be using the TikZ package, as you would expect. I'm also including the TikZ calc package, which we'll use towards the end of today's episode. I covered coordinate calculations in an earlier video, and I'll link to that in the show notes. We're going to show how to embellish some text using TikZ. Let me paste some example code over here. It's going to create a Beamer frame with some text, and we'll use that as a starting point. So here's the frame we just created. Now, suppose I want to embellish the text number of equations. My first step is to turn that bit of text into a TikZ node. If you don't already know about nodes, I'll link to that episode in the show notes. So I'll replace this bit of text here with a TikZ picture that creates a node that in turn has the text that I just deleted. When I compile that, we'll see that the text that I have is now a bit out of whack. To fix that, I need to tell TikZ how to set the baseline for this object. Right now, the bottom of this little picture we created is lined up with the bottom of the text. That's not what we want. Instead, what we want is that the baseline of that text is aligned with the baseline of the text in the node I just created. I named that node NOE. I say here that the way that we align the baseline of this picture is to have it match up with the baseline of that node. Recompiling, now things are better aligned vertically. However, if you stare at it hard, you see there's a little bit of extra space to the left and right. That's because TikZ nodes have extra padding by default, and I'll link to episodes that explain a bit more about that. To fix this issue, we'll want to set the inner separation of the node to be zero using a node option. And so we'll paste a fix to that here. It's setting the inner separation to be 0 EM. EM is one of the measures in LaTeX. And now when I recompile it, we have our node here, but you can't even tell it's a node, and now it's ready to be embellished. One way I can embellish it, for example, is I can set the background to be colored. So here I'm going to set the fill to be yellow at 25%. So that highlights the text that I just made into a node. And so that's kind of nice. Before I go on, I want to show that there's a shortcut for specifying the TikZ picture environment, and it's useful when you're using TikZ inline of text or inline of equations. So what we do is instead of having begin TikZ picture using an environment, we're just going to use the command TikZ. It still gets options, just the same as you would use for the TikZ environment, and then we'll use an open curly parenthesis, and then it ends with a closed curly parenthesis. When I compile that, nothing at all is changed. There is really no difference. It's just a matter of your personal preference. Now I'm going to want to be able to reference this node later for reasons that I'll show in a few moments. But to do that, I have to add a special option that is remember picture to the TikZ picture options. So I do that and I compile it. And again, you don't see any difference now, but we'll use that later. We can do a similar setup to make number of variables into a TikZ node. So let me go ahead and add that here. So now I've created a second node. When I compiled that, I also colored it yellow so you can see that it's working. So now I've created two nodes. One is called NOE. The other is called NOV. Both of them have the remember picture option, and now I can reference those nodes outside of the original environments in which they were created. To do this reference outside, I'm going to go ahead here and inside of the frame, but outside of the center environment, I'm going to paste another TikZ picture. The key thing here is this has two important options, remember picture and overlay. I don't use overlay in the previous ones, just remember picture, but here I'm using remember picture and then also overlay. That tells me I'm going to draw on top of what I already have. When I compile that, we'll see what happens over here on the right. Now we get some embellishments to our two nodes. So the first one, I've drawn an arrow that starts at noe.north and goes up to this node I created with the text M. And then I do a similar thing with my other node, and I have nov.south going down to the node I just created with the letter N. I set the options, remember picture and overlay. That's the key important thing. I'm also using some special styles named every path and every node to dictate the styles of what I've just drawn. I'll link to episodes that talk about styles and all these little things I'm using in the show notes. One last thing I can do that's kind of fun inside of Beamer is you can actually use pause right inside of a TikZ picture environment. And it will do this thing where it basically creates animation in your slide. It does this very manually by creating a separate slide. So in the first one, I don't have that first embellishment. Now in the next slide, I have the embellishment. And then in the final slide, I have this final embellishment. That's kind of a fun thing that you can do in Beamer. And I just want to show that it works really well with TikZ. Now let's do the same thing we just did, but with some math. I'll give an example of how to embellish an equation using TikZ. So let me paste an example frame with an equation for us to use as a starting point. I'll compile that and we'll see what we get over here. I want to add some extra information to the matrix in this equation. The first step again is to put that matrix into its own TikZ node. So I'm going to go ahead and replace this with a TikZ picture that includes a node that includes this again. I'm doing the same thing as before. I create a TikZ environment with a node inside the equation. I set the TikZ picture baseline to align with the baseline of the node that I'm creating inside this TikZ picture. And so I can remember it later. I'm using the remember picture option. One important difference from what we showed before is that here I have to surround my contents inside my node with dollar signs because it doesn't know that it's in a math environment. You may also need to use display math if you're doing an equation and you want it to be sort of doing display math just like the equation that it's inside. Even though I have the inner separation set to zero, there's still a little bit of padding on either side of the matrix, which is just because that's the part of the left and right containers. You can see this once I compiled it and you look at the fill, I can even zoom in here a bit and you can see there's just sort of a little extra space to the left and right. I mention this because it affects what we do next when we try to get everything aligned. Because I specified remember picture, I can reference the node A. I've named the node A here from outside its original picture. As before, I have to specify remember picture and overlay in the new TikZ picture that I'm going to add down here. And now I'll draw some lines on the outside of the matrix. So let me show you what the result is. So here I've drawn one line above and one line to the left, and I put nodes on them. So the first one draws the line to the left and has M equations in the middle. Here I'm using that calc package. So I'm starting at A.northwest. I'm jiggering a little bit my starting point by adding a small shift to that. And then I'm ending at A.southwest. Again, I'm doing a small shift on that. And then I'm creating midway a node to the left with the text M equations. And then the other one does something similar along the top. I'll link to the episode about node calculations in the show notes. I can again add Beamer pauses here right inside the TikZ picture environment. So let me go ahead and add one right here and another here. And then when I recompile that and zoom out, we can see now we've got a series of slides, each one adding the additional bit that we just added as our embellishment. So I hope you found today's episode on TikZ embellishments helpful. This was suggested by a watcher, so thank you for that. If you have any other shows that you'd like to see, please let me know. If you like this episode, please click like or subscribe. If you have TikZ or PGF plots questions, please post them in the comments. If you want to learn more, please check out the other videos. I also have a book, Unlocking LaTeX Graphics, available for purchase at major book retailers. Thanks for watching.